Hello there, Duncan Pollock here again. Okay, welcome to my Darksiders 100% War Master Edition. This is done in Apocalyptic difficulty, and this is the part 22 and part 2 of the Iron Canopy. Okay, so this is where I left off, and I think I do not want you guys to wait, so I want to complete Iron Canopy, upload fast and everything, so you guys do not need to wait, okay, in case you forget about this place. Okay, okay, so for this spider, okay, this is the third brute guardian. Okay, so again, you know, if you want to play with the brute guardian the normal way, prepare to lose quite a lot of health. Of course, if you're skillful and everything, should not be a problem, but with your blade Geisha, oh my god, you know, this brute guardian is, it's a joke, guys. Okay, it's a joke. Iron Canopy, it's pretty hard. It's because there's a lot of big fights. Okay, I have to highlight to you guys. Okay, I have to highlight to you guys first, all the big fights. So one more brute guardian to go. Okay, and this is the tricky part. Okay, so you have to observe how am I moving or where am I going. It's because all of my routes that I'm using right now, it's catered. Okay guys, it's catered, means it's really planned, means I can achieve all the items, and yet I can achieve all the items, and yet I can achieve the steps of it, so I do not need to backtrack. My biggest mistake is in here. Okay, do remember there is a Rafsha here. Okay guys, there is a Rafsha here. Okay, what the hell am I? Okay, correct. Okay, the reason is why I left this to now, okay, this Rafsha, it's because of this reason. Because when I fight, look at my Raf right now, okay? So you need Raf, correct? But getting this Rafsha number 12, what happens? That's the reason, guys. I regen all of my Raf again. Okay, so this is the reason why I kept it here. Okay, so that is why I didn't take it much earlier. Okay, so this is the main reason. And of course, on the right hand side, okay, I can still regen my Raf, because on the right hand side there's still a chest to get all my Raf. And here too, okay. Yep, here I can still get Raf, you see. I can still get Raf, I can still get health and everything. So all this is it's planned on the way, okay guys. But that is a mistake, means if you want to get a Raf call, Rafsha call earlier, go ahead. Okay, the number 12, go ahead. But there's, okay, but this is the steps that I'm using. Okay, and you're gonna grab all the items if you are following closely on this walkthrough. Okay guys, so right now it's the final spider, but this is important, guys. Okay, don't, okay, this is important, because do remember I told you to hold this area. Okay, don't knock the spider down, because if you knock the spider down, it's gonna lock everything. Okay, means you're gonna backtrack like crazy. Okay, backtrack like crazy. So do remember I do mention there is an item chest. Yes, it's not important, it's just an item chest, but this is 100% trophy. This is 100% walkthrough, so I have to grab everything. So do this and you will thank me, guys. You will thank me that you are not backtracking much later. Okay, it's just an item chest, so pretty random of what item you're gonna get. So for me, I've gotten Greater Life Essence, okay, but this is always different from all of the gameplay that you're gonna have. Maybe you can have Rage, maybe you can have Wrath. Okay, I do not know. So do remember, okay, yeah, I really want to highlight, because to backtrack to here, it's pretty crazy. Okay, if you knock the Brute Guardian down, okay, do remember. Okay, I will show you why if you choose. I mean, if you don't do this step, okay, so you knock the spider down, just assume you didn't take my recommendation and knock this Brute Guardian down, okay, you see? So this is what you did. So you look at the way right now. Look at the way at the back, it's locked. You see? So you can't proceed on. You have to kill the brute guardian. Then you can proceed. So that is a reason. Okay, that is a reason why I say it's okay. And backtracking, it's a really long way, guys. I'm not kidding you. Really long way. Okay, so again, do your business, and it says, oh, but for this, we're gonna have a mini boss fight. Of course, it's Brute Mother. I says, wow, with your upgrades, you know, wow, it's, you are just insane, okay, guys. And guess what? There is another health chest. Okay, so for this, there is a health chest right behind you, you see. But you want to take it, go ahead. Or you can fight the Brute Mother, then you take it. Okay, entirely up to you. Okay, entirely up to you. So for this, make sure you have the Trauma Gauntlet equipped. So this is Brute Mother. Very simple fight if you know how to deal with it again. So when he sucks, okay, that she has a pattern. So when you know this pattern, it's way simple. Okay, first thing, okay, he's gonna suck. Oh, what the hell? Ah, I missed. Okay, and this is gonna be a charge. Okay, charge. Okay. So is he good? Okay, death. Okay, so this is always the steps, okay, when he's trying to suck something. Okay, throw the bag of food, okay. And then the first thing you need to do is jump, okay, and then he'll have a shockwave, okay, shockwave three times. Okay, two times, sorry. Three times, correct. Okay, yeah, three times. Three times a shockwave, so just jump to avoid getting damage. And then the next is always a charge. Always, okay, always a charge. And then after charge, okay, so just repeat this pattern, okay, and then just hurt her enough. Okay, when you do this, back off three jumps. So one, okay, so just jump three times, and then she's gonna charge. Okay, she's gonna charge, so just run towards the direction, you know, and dodged, and again grab the thing, you know. It is like a, it's like the same old thing, you know, this Brute Mother. Okay, this Brute Mother is doing the same thing, right? That is why it's so easy, okay, and jump three times. And then he's gonna charge again. Okay, so that's how simple it is, okay, once you know the steps. Okay, and this should be the last. Okay, this scene is like Starship Troopers. If you guys seen the movie, okay. But of course, war make it more epic. Okay, so Three Souls Forest. Okay, so this will unlock the passage to Silith. Okay, so there is a health chest. Okay, if you didn't grab it, well, I'm in full chest, but I have to grab it. If not, this will lock in to my hot seeker, so you see, on my map. So even after doing this, okay, there is a lot of big fights, as I say, ambush, big fights, party, or whatever you want to call it, okay. Again, I've forgotten what is her name. Seriously, I totally forgotten what I did. I know I called her Medusa, but I know it's not Medusa, but totally forgotten what is the name for it. Spellcasters or whatever. But one thing good is because we have the grapple chain now. So grapple chain, okay. Yeah, it's way easier, okay, way easier right now because of the Abyssia chain, sorry. So abuse your Abyssia chain, okay, this fight, it's pretty much simple because now we can reach to her because of the chains. Of course, we all know she's not the only enemy that will hold you. There will be much more. But, okay, guys, do remember, you have Chaos Form. Okay, you have Chaos Form and you have Blade Gaisha. So don't worry about it, okay, guys. Don't worry about it. Just use them. If you like Chaos Form, use Chaos Form. If you like Blade Gaisha, use Blade Gaisha. Okay, do whatever works well for you. And of course, this undead champions, waste of time. They only generate souls, okay, so thanks. Okay, Blade Gaisha is good. Oh, that's fast. I know there are much more bigger enemies for us to kill, but I just don't know what it is because it really doesn't matter. But do remember my skills is all default, okay? I mean my Chaos Eater. My Chaos Eater is still the default. I didn't upgrade any skills. I know a lot of people would prefer to upgrade Chaos Eater. Okay, I just wanna do the counter. Okay, there. Okay, I just wanna do the counter. Okay, there you are. So these are the last sets, Blade Gaisha, definitely. Come on. Ouch, ouch, really, really ouch. Can I grab it? Ah, nearly. If not, if that's it. Wasting time. Okay, smile for the camera again. Smile. Okay, so that's it. Pretty much simple. Okay, this is important, guys. No matter what, this is important. I know we have already gotten all of the enhancements, okay, but this is the legendary enhancement, and I strongly recommend you remember this, okay? It's just right on top of us with the Hot Seeker, okay? Because this is the best enhancements for Chaos Eater, okay? The best. No doubt, the best, okay? This is a legendary enhancement, by the way. So, what is it? It's actually War's Glory. Okay, the stats of this is crazy, guys, I tell you. Okay, so please remember to grab this, okay? Okay, see? Legendary. All the enhancement is complete. But what does Legendary does, okay? Okay, look at the slot bonus, passive bonus. Crazy, I tell you, crazy. This is definitely the best. War's Glory is the best, okay, for Chaos Eater. So just make sure this is your endgame, definitely. Okay, so the War's Glory, okay, and the position for this legendary is very nice. There are four, okay, there are four. So War's Glory eventually is a war. Means it pretty much sums up like the Darksiders is throwing you a bone or an Easter egg, okay? Like, what to do? Look at that, okay? Okay, none of the enhancements can beat this, okay? So this is how Chaos Eater looks from now to the end of the game. Okay, so each means all of the legendary enhancements, okay, correct? They will have their own. Means it's like a little Easter egg of what the Horseman does and everything. Okay, so definitely War's Glory is for war. Okay, so it represents the Horseman of the Apocalypse, war. Okay, so that is the thing that you need to know. And I strongly recommend you guys. I mean, if you miss this, oh my god. Because now, okay, doing this. What the hell, guys? Okay, doing this. What does it does? Means, okay, your Chaos Form is now extend. Means when you are in Chaos Form, it extend the period. and then everything Chaos Eater, now your weapon experience is also increased. And the best thing, your damage for Chaos Eater is also increased. Oh my god, that's, you know, everything is on the slot and passive. All the abilities and all the enhancements are all there. Okay guys, I mean, crazy, crazy, crazy. Okay, there is still another big fight. Okay, so he's supposed to caught us by surprise, but no big deal guys. Okay, you still have quite a lot of, what's that, Blade Geisha and Chaos Fog. No way. I mean, this, see, the big problem about the Iron Canopy is because if you don't do your upgrades right, okay, if you don't do your upgrades right, all this will drain you up eventually. Okay guys, this will drain you up, the fights will drain your health, and of course if you don't collect your collectibles, it's gonna be hard. It's because you do not have the rough bars, you know, to maintain all this. So it's good to, you know, that is why I say it's pretty hard. But if you are following this walkthrough, I mean, your rough bar is crazy, you know, all this stuff, that's it, you know. And of course, golem champion or what, but it doesn't matter. Okay, use up all my what's that, rough, but it's okay. I still have a chaos form guys, don't forget. Anymore. Okay, no chaos form used. Oh, by the way, if you would if you were to use your chaos form, it's now extend. Okay, it's 1.5 more time duration extra. Okay, how many seconds extra? I don't know, but it's around 1.5. Okay, the bar moves slower when you're in chaos form. Okay, so that's it. The Psy is just up, but I'm not gonna do the Psy level up. So can you imagine I'm leveling up two accounts? Okay, no way I'm doing that. Okay, pretty simple. Okay, so that is the route that we need to go, and I'm still living a health chest there. But okay, so okay, you can take a look at my this map. Okay, right now. Okay, so there's one health chest there. Okay, still do remember I leave a rough core chest, but it's pretty confusing when you look at it like that. I know what it is because I've been running this Iron Canopy, so it's pretty easy for me to know which chest is which chest. Okay, but for you, it might not. So guess what, I'm just gonna take it. Okay, just for the walkthrough purpose, okay. Just for this guide, I'm gonna take it. But my advice to you, if you are doing the weapon leveling up, okay. Okay, all this, okay, you can see all the chests taken. Of course, the dark gray, you can't count them because I haven't been through that area yet. So it's just two chests, okay? Two chests, okay? The dark gray area and the artifact, you can't do anything to it, okay? There's nothing I can do because I need to go there and defeat Silith. Then I can grab it. So two chests. So these two chests is... Okay, I do remember, don't grab this chest, okay? Don't grab this chest if you're doing the weapon upgrades, okay? But I'm just doing it for this purpose, for this walkthrough purpose, okay? Okay, so I've been highlighting you a lot because this is important guys, okay? It will help you a lot, this chest. And right now I will just show you the way to go back, okay? In case you want to, this is just a little trial of how you do your weapon announcement. So this is the room. Okay, but I'll show you a proper video. But in case you are lost and you want to backtrack stuff, you know, sometimes for some reasons I do not know why, you want to backtrack some stuff. So this is how you go back. You know, it's very confusing, guys. This is the way I'm trying to show you, like how you go to the beginning where you were captured. Okay, so there it is. Okay, it seems very easy, correct, guys? But I mean, if you guys are playing it, you are definitely gonna get lost. Okay, mark my words. Okay, guys. Of course, unless you are very good, you know, you are a very good map reader and everything. Of course, you know, you can memorize things very, very well. So this is the way, because right now I'm just trying to grab Yurafsha, okay? Yurafsha. And do not worry, because Sileth boss fight, you do not need Rafsha, okay? You do not need Raf. You do not need much of the Blade Geisha and all this stuff. Okay, so this is the last chest, okay? As I do mention, it's just see? So doing this, I've completed all of the chests. Okay, you guys can see it. Okay, of course I have to defeat Sileth. Okay. So that's it, guys. I mean, see? So right now, all the items that I can get, all that I can grab before the boss fight, it's all catered. Okay, and then after Sileth fight, I'll let you see this whole map. It's totally, you won't see any artifact and you won't see any chest, to make it clear that I've gotten everything. Okay, so right now, there's nothing much to do, because you guys know, for a boss fight, I will always make a brand new part just on boss fight. Okay, so that's how you go back. Okay, guys, I really hope it helps. I know it's stupid to show to you like, hey, I really know it, but some players is gonna have a problem in just going back, because they are gonna get lost. They are always stuck, you know. It's like a roundabout thing. Why am I always roundabout, and why am I always stuck in here? So I showed you a way, like how to go back in the beginning, you know, so you can navigate yourself also. Okay, worst case scenario, but you know, if you just miss an item, you can use this route. But again, as I say, if you're watching part 1 and this part 2, eventually you have already grabbed all the items. I mean, if you watch carefully, okay, and you're following, okay. And by the way, guys, it's not easy, okay, I have to highlight that. It's not easy doing a walkthrough like that to show you, oh, this is the route to do the steps, you know, to do the steps for grabbing this, right? Because if you are looking at other walkthroughs, I guarantee you they will backtrack. Some gamers, players or what, they will have to backtrack. But I felt the route from my part 1 and this part 2, practically speaking, you do not need to backtrack anything, okay? Except for the Rafsha, of course. Except for the Rafsha. But I purposely live it, okay? You guys have to understand. I purposely live it so I can show you a route, you know? I will show you a route of how I go back to the beginning in case you are lost. If not, you know, I totally do not need it and I can just go ahead to the Sileth fight. So this is just a teaser, okay, and now I'm using Trauma Gauntlet. So this is the Earthbreaker, as I mentioned. Okay, but I will mention why it's good for Earthbreaker. Okay, guys, you guys know I'm just wasting time, because, okay, guys, sorry about it, but, you know. Okay, so, let me see. Okay, and don't do this, because, okay, you look at my Trauma Gauntlet, okay. Always remember, equip your combat lore, this skill, towards the weapon that you always want to upgrade. Okay, that's one thing I want to highlight. And then pretty much we are at the entrance of where we are supposed to fight Sileth. Okay, so I mean, this should be, and there will be another health chest, which this game is good. Because in case you are low on health, do not worry, because at the Silith entrance, there is always a health chest. That's why Darksiders is pretty generous, pretty generous. Okay. Okay, I mean that's it, so you just grab the health chest. Okay, Silith. Okay, I think I got the name right. It's called Silith. Okay. So that's it, guys. I mean, thanks for watching and everything. Greatly appreciate everything, and I'll see you guys next on the part 23, I believe. And the most important thing, good luck in the apocalyptic run. Cheers.